Okay, this is the blind speed. Is it okay? Where n is varying from 1, 2, 3, and so on. Okay, where vn is the nth blind speed. Is it okay? If the question is like that, determine the first and second blind speed, then simply you have to keep n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, and so on. Okay, let us consider this is an example. Okay, in a MTI radar, the pulse repetition frequency is 200 hertz, then FP they have given, and the carrier transmission frequency is 100 megahertz, FT they have given. Find its first, second, and third blind speed. FP is equal to 200 hertz, FT is equal to 100 megahertz. We know that wavelength lambda is equal to c by the transmitted frequency. C is the velocity of propagation, velocity of light, 3 into 10 power 8. FT is equal to 100 megahertz they have given, 100 into 10 power 6, which is equal to 3 meter. Then nth blind speed, we know that the nth blind speed formula is vn is equal to n into lambda by 2 into t. Then 1 by t is nothing but FP. Okay, if n is equal to 1, which gives the first blind speed. If n is equal to 2, which gives the second blind speed. If n is equal to 3, which gives the third blind speed. Okay, the blind speed units are meters per second. Why? Because there is a t here, you have to write meters per second. Is it clear? This is an example of blind speed. Is it okay? Okay, this is a maximum unambiguous range. That means maximum unwanted range. Okay, this is the maximum unwanted range. Is it okay? First blind, okay, here is the output, then it is a maximum unwanted range. Is it clear? If you observe, this is the maximum unwanted range, 5 megahertz. Is it okay? Then coming to the next, double cancellation. Is it okay? Double cancellation. As we discuss in the delay line filter, okay, we are going to get some required AC components. The DC components are going to be blocked, but it will not happen always. Okay, practically, if we talk about some DC components are present like this only. To overcome that drawback present in the single delay line canceller, we are going to move some double cancellation technique. Is it clear? If you observe this, the frequency response of a single delay line canceller, okay, whatever we have shown in figure, does not always have as broad a clutter rejection. That means clutter means you all know that stationary target rejection, okay, null. That means zero, as might be desired in the vicinity of DC. Okay, the clutter rejection notches may be widened by passing the output of the delay line canceller through a second delay line canceller as shown in figure, like this. We can also call this as a cascaded delay line canceller. Is it okay? Then it is a three pulse canceller. How it is going to be convert is nothing but simply, okay, if you observe the difference between these two figure, it is taking like this. That's why we are going to say that it is a three pulse delay line canceller. Is it okay? If you observe why the delay is going to be cancelled, means it is a plus one, then reciprocal of this is minus one. These two are going to be cancelled. It is minus one, then plus one. If you observe this, it is a plus two, here plus one and plus one, plus two, then it is a minus two. Why? Because it is already a minus one, then it is minus one. Okay. By this, we are going to achieve this part. That means what is this means? Okay. Clutter rejection notches may be widened by passing the output of the delay line canceller through a second delay line canceller. Is it okay? This is the concept of double cancellation. Is it okay? Then coming to the frequency response of the single delay line canceller. Okay. Yeah. This is the frequency response. If you observe that, the frequency response of single delay canceller and the frequency response of the double delay line canceller. Is it okay? Here, the solid line represents the single cancellation technique, the dotted line representation the double cancellation technique. Is it clear if you observe that? Is it okay? This is a single and this is a double cancellation technique. Is it okay? You have to draw this. If you observe this, for every okay pulse repetition frequency, we are going to consider the spectrum. Is it okay? This is about the double cancellation technique. Is it clear, all of you? The next topic is multiple war or staggered PRFs. Multiple war or staggered pulse repetition frequencies. Okay, the use of more than one pulse repetition frequency offers additional flexibility in the design of MTI Doppler filters. Okay, the use of this PRF. Okay, it is going to be provide better frequency stability or flexibility we will talk about. Okay, why? Because it not only reduces the effect of blind speed, but it also allows a sharper lower frequency cutoff in the frequency response than might be obtained with a cascade of single delay line cancellers with this. Okay, this is very important one. You have to write up to this. Why? Because by using a pulse repetition frequency, we have additional flexibility in the design. It not only reduces the effect of blind speeds, it also allows a sharper lower frequency cutoff in the frequency response than might be obtained in the cascade of single delay line canceller. We will just cross-check this. The blind speeds of two independent radars operating at the same frequency will be different if their pulse repetition frequencies are different. It is very clear. Why? Because pulse repetition frequency different means the blind speed is also different. Therefore, if one radar were blind, okay, then automatically the other is also a blind. No need to use two blind radars here. Instead of using two separate radars, the same result can be obtained with one radar. Okay, which time shares using two separate radars. The result can be obtained with one radar with time shares its pulse repetition frequency between two or more different values. This is going to be called as multiple pulse repetition frequency. That means what I am trying to say here is the blind speeds of two independent radars operating at the same frequency will be different if their pulse repetition frequency are different. That's why no need to consider two blind speed radars. Instead of that, consider one blind speed radar and operate it with different pulse repetition frequency. That is a multiple pulse repetition frequency. With the help of this property, we are going to reduce the blind speed radar. That's why the effect of blind speed is going to be reduced. Is it clear? That is the main concept here. If you observe this, the pulse repetition frequency might be switched every time the antenna is scanned to a half beam width or the period. Is it okay? Then this switching action is going to be called as staggered. Okay, whenever the antenna is going to be scanned every time, then the pulse repetition frequency might be switched. Is it clear, all of you? Then if you observe this, is it okay? Then if you observe these figures, this is the response for some pulse repetition frequency. Then this is the response for the same radar for some different pulse repetition frequency. The composite signal of these two, it will be look like the frequency response of a single delay line canceller. This is with some pulse repetition frequency, same with the different pulse repetition frequency. This is the composite response. Is it clear, all of you? This is the staggered response switching action if you observe this. Okay, why? Because as I already said that the staggered PRF is nothing but, okay, whenever the antenna is going to be scanned, okay, whenever the antenna is going to be scanned, if you observe this point very clear, we have said that, okay, when the switching, if you observe this, every time the antenna is scanned, half beam width or the period might be alternated on every other pulse, then the switching pulse to pulse is known as staggered pulse repetition frequency. Is it okay? This is regarding this. Is range gated Doppler filters. Okay, range gated Doppler filters. As we know that the delay line cancellers, which can be considered as a time domain filter, has been widely used in MTA radar as a means for separating moving targets from stationary targets. Is it clear? Undesirable stationary clutters. It is also possible to employ the more useful frequency domain bandpass filters of conventional design in MTA radar. Okay, to sort the Doppler frequency shifted targets. Is it clear? That means not only in time domain, we can also elaborate the same concept with the help of frequency domain by using the bandpass filters. frequency domain bandpass filters. This is range gated. Range gate is nothing but we have to decide the range by adding some bandpass filters. That means by adding some gates. That's why we are going to call it as range gated. Okay, as usual, it's a Doppler filter. Is it clear? Then if you observe this, a block diagram of the video of an MTA radar with multiple range gates followed by cluster rejection filters is shown in figure. Why? Because if you observe the figures of this after phase detection, you have to give to the delay line canceller. Instead of giving to the delay line canceller, if you given to the range gated Doppler filter, that means the phase detector output should be given to this figure. The phase detector output should be given to the range gated Doppler filter. If you observe this, the phase detector output is divided into some ranges, range gate number 1, number 2, number 3. Then you have to use some bandpass filters there. Then this is the boxcar generator. That means it is nothing but sample and hold circuitry. These are the gates, okay, which is very helpful to pass this information. As previously I said, it is a bandpass filter. Sorry for that. It is a gate which allows the output of phase detector. Is it okay? Which allows the output of phase detector, right? Okay, then thereafter, we have to sample it and we have to hold. Then we have to choose some Doppler filter, that is a bandpass filter. Then we have to perform full wave linear detector operation, then integrity with the help of low pass filter, then threshold. Then we have to pass to the data processing. This is very important. Is it okay? I think you are very clear with the concept of range gated Doppler filters. That means not only in time domain filter, we have to use a frequency domain filter also. Okay, the output of phase detector is divided into, okay, some number of functions with the help of some range gateds. Then thereafter, we have to use a sample and hold circuit, that is a boxcar generator. Then we have to pass to the bandpass Doppler filter. Then full wave followed by full wave linear detector, low pass filter like this and so on. Okay, the description is given here very simply. If you observe this, a block diagram of the video of an MTA radar with multiple range gates followed by clutter rejection filters, that means bandpass filters, is shown in figure. The output of the phase detector is sampled sequentially by the range gates. Each range gate opens in sequence just long enough to sample the voltage of the video waveforms corresponding to a different range interval in space, right? The range gate acts as a switch here, as I said, or a gate which opens and closes at the proper time. The range gates are activated once each pulse repetition interval. Is it okay? The output of the, again, you have to write from this. The output of the range gates stretched in a circuit called the boxcar generator or a sample and hold circuit, whose purpose is to aid or store in the filtering and detection process by emphasizing the fundamental of the modulation frequency and eliminate some harmonics. Is it clear? Thereafter, it is followed by some full wave linear detector. If you observe this, following the Doppler filter is a full wave linear detector and an integrated low pass filter. The purpose of the detector is to convert the bipolar video to unipolar. The output of the integrator is applied to a threshold detection circuit. Only those signals which cross the threshold are reported as targets. Is it clear? You have to write up to this. Okay, this is the bandpass filter. This is the frequency response. I think it is clear to you. Okay. The next topic is limitations to MTA performance. Okay. The improvement in signal to clutter ratio, that means we have to improve the signal ratio, we have to reduce the clutter ratio. The overall, we are going to call it a signal to clutter ratio of an MTA, is affected by factors other than the design of the Doppler signal processors. Okay. Before going to discuss about what are the effects due to the limitations to degrade the performance is nothing but, just we will concentrate some definitions, MTA, which are important for your 2 marks question. MTA improvement factor, just go through the definitions. The signal to clutter ratio at the output of the MTA system divided by the signal to clutter ratio at the input, averaged uniformly over all target radial velocities of interest. Then subclutter instability, the ratio by which the target echo power may be weaker than the coincident clutter echo power and still be detected. Is it okay? Then after that, clutter visibility factor. the signal to clutter issue after cancellation or Doppler filtering that provides stated probabilities of detection and false alarm.